Hello there and welcome to The Visioner. My name is Anne, I'm the creator of this platform, so I guess you can call me Anne The Visioner. Through this channel, I'll be sharing content about travel, visa, and immigration related topics. So if you're curious or you find that interesting, be sure to subscribe and turn on the notification bell just so that you don't miss out on any information that I have coming your way. So how do I go about making the actual application for the DB Lottery 2022? In my last video, I took you through the requirements of the DB Lottery. If you've not watched that video, be sure to watch it immediately after this. And today, I'm gonna take you through the exact step-by-step procedure on how to submit your actual application. I'm gonna be looking at the screen, which I believe you can see right in front of you. The first thing would be to go to the website, which is www.dvlottery.state.gov. So once you're there, you're gonna see the form, the welcome page, and you immediately go to the button, this green button right here. You click on it to begin your entry, and you'll have an authentication code. So I'm just gonna put the identification code, and once you do, you'll now be taken to this page, and you can see right here it says the U.S. Department of State Bureau of Consular Affairs. But first thing, the most important pass is to go on part one, which is the entrant information, and you'll be asked first thing for your family name, so you'll be able to put there your family name and first name and then your middle name. So in case you do not have a first name or a middle name, you can tick in whichever box over here. So if I don't have a first name, I would be able to tick on this box, so it's automatically disabled, so you're not able to include any details there. You click on whatever gender. The third part is to put your date of birth. So you put the month, the date, and the year, and then the city where you were born. In case you do not know, there's a button here you can press, birth city unknown. Finally, number five, the country where you were born. So you select a country from all this. All the countries basically are there. If it's you're from Kenya, you can just select Kenya. Then number six, you'll be asked the country of eligibility for the DV lottery. So there are only specific countries that are permitted to apply for the DV lottery. So based on your nationality, you'd be able to know whether you're eligible to apply for this or not. Your country of eligibility will normally be the same as your country of birth. It's not related to where you live currently at present. So it's basically where you were born. If you were born in a country that is not eligible for the DV program, please go to explanation of country of eligibility to see if there's another program available in your case. So for that case, you will not be able to apply for the DV lottery. So the first thing would be to check if your country is eligible for the DV lottery program prior to applying, as mentioned in my previous video. For this case, Kenya is specifically eligible to apply for the DV lottery. They ask you, are you claiming eligibility based on the country you were born? If you're not, you must enter the country from which you're claiming eligibility. So in case you say no, you'll be able to choose from this part. So number seven, it's the passport details. So the first thing, you put your family name, which is your surname or your last name. And then here you put your first name and then your middle name. Then you go ahead and put your passport number. And then at this point, you put the passport expiry detail. So personally, I have my passport here. I'll be able to check on the biodata page, and you put in your month of when you were born and the day you were born and the year. And then you go on to fill country stroke authority of issuance. It was issued by the government of Kenya. For this case, I'll just put Kenya. So let's proceed to part B of number seven. They are asking in case you're exempted to have a passport, they want to know more information as to whether you have a passport exemption. And if you do, what are the reasons? Here, you can see, I am required not to submit passport information because either, number one, I'm stateless, I don't have any nationality, a national of a communist-controlled country and unable to obtain a passport from my government, unable to obtain a passport and have received an individual waiver of the passport requirement by the Secretary of Homeland Security or Secretary of State. So in case any of this applied to you and you don't have a passport with good reason, with reasons of exemption, then you're able to select one of these. Majority of the people will not actually fall in this category. And remember, one of the main requirements of the DV lottery is for you to have a passport and submit your passport details. So moving on to part 8, which is details about your passport picture, the digital passport picture that you took. So they say here that photographs that do not comply with all specifications, and they go further to explain what those specifications are, they're saying must be taken in the last 6 months. So that's one. Composition of the photo and acceptable backgrounds are grounds for disqualification of the entire entry. So if your picture is not a recent picture or one that's taken within the last 6 months, that's automatic disqualification. And they have the tools and the systems to know when the picture was actually taken. So if it's not a picture that's taken within the last 6 months, you'll be automatically disqualified. That's one. The second thing is if it does not compose exactly what they want captured in the picture, it will be disqualified. And thirdly, if the background is unacceptable, then the picture you'll also be disqualified based on the picture not being acceptable or as per the standards that they specify. So you need to make sure that your picture complies with all these three requirements. They also go further and say that any manipulation of photographs that alters the facial characteristics is ground for disqualification of the entire entry. So don't manipulate the face or any facial characteristics. And they go on to say that there are further examples of the pictures. Feel free to click and see what exactly is required for the pictures. Once that's done, so you go to part number 9. This is details about your mailing address. So in care of who should it be addressed to? So you put all your full names. You can put your address as per how you receive your letters. And then you include the city or the town and the province for if it's Nairobi or if it's whichever province. And then your city zip code or postal code. And then finally, you put your country, the country of this mailing address. So let's proceed to number 10. Here, they would want to know which country you're currently living at. So you can go ahead and select whichever country. They don't assume where you were born is necessarily where you live now. So much as you're applying the DV lottery based on your nationality or where you were born, here, they want details as to where you're currently living now. And then you will go ahead and include your phone number, and that's optional, but definitely your email address. So you can fill in your email address at number 12 and you further confirm it. You rewrite your full email address. Okay. And then number 13, they want to know which is the highest level of education that you've achieved as of today. So all this is based on your academic achievement. There is a disclaimer here. They go ahead and say that you must have a minimum of a high school diploma reflecting the completion of a full course of study or be a skilled worker in an occupation that requires at least 2 years of training or experience to qualify. This is for the people that have had some high school education but have not yet graduated. So that's where they click, but they will still be disqualified unless you have 2 years vocational training and work experience, then you may not qualify. If you've finished high school, then you click high school degree. If you have done some college training or have gone to vocational school, that means anything higher than high school certificate. You've finished high school and you've done some further studies after that. That's where you click. If you have finished a degree, then go ahead and say that you have that degree, whether it's bachelor's degree or undergraduate degree or master's degree or doctorate degree. If you're just embarking on your studies and you've not yet graduated, then you say some studies, like some university courses, some graduate level courses, or some doctorate level courses. Let's now further proceed to part 14, where they ask, what is your current marital status? Here, you're required to confirm whether are you single and have never been married. So if you are, then you click unmarried. However, if you're married and your spouse is not a US citizen or permanent resident, and a lawful permanent resident at that, as they've clearly specified, then you click there. You also are required to say whether you're married if your spouse is a US citizen. You're also meant to confirm whether you're divorced, widowed, or legally separated. So if you're divorced or widowed, they will not require any documentation at this point in time. However, at the time of being selected, if you're lucky, they will definitely require this information. They will require further details on either your divorce certificate or death certificate of your spouse, but that's at a later phase if you're chosen. If you're legally separated, they will require for you to enter information about your spouse, but please note that in no way will you be allowed to go with the spouse in case you do win the green card lottery. Just because you were legally separated at the time of making this application. So let's proceed to part 15. They will require to know whether you have any children, and if you do, you list how many you have, and this can be either biological children, adopted children, stepchildren. You can all include them in the application as long as they are under 21 years and as long as they're not married. You can include them in your application. And so once you fill all this information, you click on continue, and then it will take you to a page whereby you just need to verify all the information that you've provided. In case there's an error, you'll need to edit. So just go through the exact form as per what you've already filled, verify that all the information that you've put there is accurate, and then you'll click on submit. So once you click submit, it will process the information that you've submitted, and you'll get a confirmation that your entry has been received successfully. It will look something like this, what you're seeing currently on your screen. It will have the entrant name, so it will have your full name as per your passport, and importantly, it will have your confirmation number. So make sure that you have that confirmation number. It's one of the most important things. I would recommend that you save this form just because it's really, really important, especially when you're checking your results come May. So I would recommend that you, even if you do not have a printer, I would still recommend that you go ahead and click on print. And then instead of printing, you save as PDF. So there it is, guys. It's actually not a long process. It's so straightforward. I hope that you are also going to make your application. The chances of winning are slim, but it's definitely worth it. So go try. You never know if you're lucky up until you actually win and win big. So thank you for watching. Comment down below if you've already made your application or if you're about to make your application. Thanks, guys. Subscribe.